Now, back to Access Tech Live, the latest in tech and accessibility with Stephen Scott and Mark Aflalo.
Welcome back to Access Tech Live. I am Stephen Scott. Mark Aflalo is with me as always. And, you know, it wouldn't be a tech show if we didn't talk about AI at some point. But interesting where this particular topic comes from, because we're talking about the people who create the technology that, I guess, makes AI possible, right?
Yeah, totally. Back at CES, Stephen, there was a really cool AI demo on stage that was a demonstration of Intel's Omnibridge technology, which basically allows someone who's deaf to communicate with someone who isn't in real time. And no, the person who was not deaf could not read sign language, okay? The obvious question there. So we're going to play you a little clip of this demo from CES 2024. It's with Jim Johnson, the Senior Vice President and General Manager of Client Business Group at Intel.
And so a company with an Intel Omnibridge has been developing technology so the deaf can communicate with someone like me without the use of an interpreter. So I'm going to invite Adam Munder into the conversation. He's the co-founder and general manager, and his team has created technology to enable this. Let's show it in action.
So what's happening now is that he's on stage across from Adam, and he's actually signing this.
Hello, Adam. How are you?
Then after he just said that, Adam looks at his computer, which gives him the transcription of what was just said. Adam then reads it on the screen, and he signs back, "I am good. I am happy to be here today." And then the computer transcribes that sign language to text. He also added, "How are you doing today?"
I'm doing really well, thank you. Intel Omnibridge software is an example of how we're working together to make it easier for people like us to communicate day to day.
So then after just a couple of seconds after he says that, again, the text appears on screen. Adam reads it, and then he signs back to the computer, "I love how we use AI for technology good."
I couldn't agree more. Now we're having a conversation with Core Ultra Systems, your AI software, without an interpreter. I believe you are running this on this Core Ultra laptop, correct?
And he goes on to answer yes, which means that all that demo was actually physically on that device, Stephen, and no cloud involvement whatsoever. So you know, it's pretty cool. So when we saw that, we realized, okay, we have to learn more about this. We gotta figure out what's going on here. So we caught up with Intel's Director of Accessibility, Darrell Adams, and touched not only on that demo, but what accessibility means to a company like Intel.
Darrell Adams is the Director of Accessibility at Intel. Darrell, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me. I appreciate it.
Darrell, earlier this year, you guys demonstrated something pretty amazing at CES, and that was something called Omnibridge. It allowed two people, one just like me and one person who is deaf, to communicate in real time thanks to computer vision, basically deciphering adult sign language and turning it into the written word and vice versa. It blew my mind. Was that the reaction from others as well?
Well, I think it's the same for many people. I think that when you think about the idea of simulating sign language, it is such a compelling idea and it's such a difficult problem. So for many years, I think teams have been trying to solve this problem to really address that barrier between the deaf community and the hearing community. And it turns out that at Intel, we have a deaf engineer who's a long-term engineer at the company. He's been around about 16 years doing silicon engineering. And he's, in order to do his job, he's completely dependent on sign language interpreters to interact with the rest of his peers. And so he finally came to the point where he realized, he's like, I think I can solve this. And so he put together a proposal. And that proposal ended up being fully funded and supported as an internal venture at Intel, which I thought was remarkable in its own right, that he'd be able to influence to the point where he was able to now get this entire project funded and resourced. And so for the last few years, they've been working diligently on it, and it's really come to the point where it's basically the world's largest high-quality data set for sign language. And it's coming along. And as you saw with the demo, it's becoming quite compelling. And I think they're onto something, and really looking forward to seeing how this really turns up in the real world, and would love to really see it on the PC. And so that ultimately that's my goal, is to see this at scale able to help everyone.
Intel has been around the block a couple of times now, Darrell, innovating and working on technology that is years away. Now, that being said, and having worked at Intel for a while now, are you surprised anymore by the speed of which things like AI are being developed?
Yes and no. It's hard to imagine when you see something for the first time that is just a step, such an advanced step forward. But in reality, at the pace at which we advance technology, compute in general, it's near exponential. And so it shouldn't be a surprise when we see significant leaps forward, but it is, because it's just amazing. You have an understanding of what you think your interaction with a computer looks like, or your interaction with a phone looks like, and then something so completely new and exciting comes along. It's like, wow, I can't believe we're here. But I think this is really just the beginning. I think that, as we know, AI has been around for decades. And as we've been in the labs working very hard on things like natural language processing and computer vision and more of these traditional AI workloads, we've seen the potential to basically rethink how that relationship with technology, that not everything has to run through a keyboard and a mouse into a screen. And now that we have, over the past couple of years, as you're alluding, with generative AI, and this is showing us the power of what can be. And I think I look at this as just examples. We're just kind of creating a new language for ourselves, saying like, well, this is what computing can do. It's not science fiction. But ultimately, the way that this transforms how we behave with our technology, how we, like, an actual relationship with technology, is going to be fundamental. And I think this is going to continue to, that this rapid rate of change is going to continue. So we need to get used to that, I think.
A lot of people are talking about using AI on device. Now, what that means is no cloud computing, everything is on the device, which makes it more secure. Are we at a point now where, technology speaking, we have enough power on device to do the things we want to do?
So I'll say yes and no again. Like the Intel Core Ultra that was unveiled earlier this year, AI PC. So what we're talking about is a general purpose processor with a graphics processor, so CPU, GPU, and then the new kid on the block being the neural processor, so the NPU. And the reason why that's important is that when you design the silicon, the process to very specifically to manage and to optimize AI workloads, you gain efficiencies in power and performance at the cost that a consumer would expect to be able to do these things. But also keep in mind that we're going to continue to evolve these processors generation over generation for year over year. And it is near exponential. And so something that we see as state of the art today, in 3 or 4 years, it's going to be significantly more capable. Our CEO has a number of times, Pat Gelsinger, has noted that he has line of sight to a trillion transistor chip. It's a lot of transistors, a lot of processing. And that's also not science fiction. That's something that is kind of that you can see happening in the decade.
Yeah, exactly. Darrell, talk to me about what accessibility means to you at Intel.
For me, it comes into play everywhere. So in my role as director of accessibility, it's kind of two hats. One is that traditional accessibility role where we want to be a company that is inclusive and accessible to all employees and is a great place to work for employees with disabilities. And so everything that means around the digital experience, the physical experience, the culture are all things that I'm interested in evolving and improving over time. And that's half of my job. The other part is about more along the lines of what we've been talking about today, where it's about what is Intel as a company, what is our role in the industry to produce and create a future of technology that is more inclusive and more accessible to more people. And the way that it plays out for me partially is that we are making a big bet on user experience. And as we, you know, and we have a corporate goal commitment to ensure that every one of our user experience professionals, so whether it's user experience research or design, will adopt fully inclusive design practices in their work by 2030. So that, and that, what that means is that everything that we do that touches the user will involve direct insights from people with disabilities, from the research, the general research, to the product design, to the testing, throughout. We're doing that with employees and with people outside of the company to ensure that those insights are part of the process and understood. And ideally, from my perspective, is bringing more and more people into the mix, onto the teams as well, that have disabilities. So that's a big key piece to it. But I think it's, and the other thing that we're, that helps drive that sort of North Star around just making these platforms more accessible over time, is that we're committed that year over year, each platform will be more accessible than the previous one. And so it's a little bit generic, but it gives us this notion that as we're designing the next generation, we have to be thinking about what is the thing that we need to think about this year that can make this better than it was. And this year's focus is all around improved hearing aid compatibility and hearing experience for people that have hearing loss across the board. And we'll continue just to push on down that path, as well as implementing new capabilities for vision loss and motor mobility challenges as well.
Are you finding that your partners are embracing what you're putting on the table and developing and taking and running with it?
Yes, I think we're seeing definitely an uptick across the board with the industry relationships. And I think that is also probably another key point here, is that all of this that we're talking about is, it's never one company. It's imperative that we have strong relationships across the industry, whether it's Intel with Microsoft or Google or any of the PC computer manufacturers. We need to work together so we can develop not only more accessible and usable solutions, but things that are consistent and standardized. So it's not like you go and buy one computer that does the thing that you need, and then the next computer doesn't. We need to think of these capabilities as sort of table stakes, things that just must happen and happen in a consistent fashion.
Darrell Adams, the Director of Accessibility at Intel, thank you for joining us.
It's been a pleasure, Mark. Appreciate you having me on.
When we come back here on Access Tech Live, Stephen's been hunkering down and putting together what he thinks are the top 5 AI accessibility tips. What does that even mean? We'll find out after a quick break. Stick around.
There's more Access Tech Live to come. Get involved and have your say at Access Tech Live on social media. We'll be right back.